After my PhD, I came back to Sri Lanka to work at something called the Arthur C Clarke Centre for Modern Technologies, Modern Communication Technologies. So obviously you don't get to know the guy who it's named for when you're a junior person. But somehow, you know, he was quite approachable and he talked to me, asked me what I was doing. And when I said what I was doing, which was trying to get Sri Lanka connected to DARPANET or something like that, which was the assignment I had been given, get connected to databases in the US. That was, I think, the way it was written. So he said, oh, why don't you come over? So I went to his house and he had a lifetime free CompuServe subscription. So there was no cost on that. But on the other hand, in order to get to the CompuServe, you had to use telephony, which was like gold those days. So all he said is, you know, why don't you play with it and don't spend too much money? I mean, don't be extravagant. But I was on it for half an hour. I think you'd have suffered some substantial financial damage. So after the tsunami, we were working on, you know, ground level stuff about how to deal with early warning, how to prevent the recurrence of what happened, where 30,000 people died without warning when warning could have been given. And that's connected us to WorldSpace, which was a satellite-based kind of personalized broadcasting radio. It was satellite radio, let's say. And they developed a new technology, a completely new technology for addressable, remotely addressable, activable, localized. That is, we could give one warning to Hambantota and another one to Kandy, not the same thing, because of its ability to target. Really wonderful technology. And they brought the bits and pieces to Sri Lanka as soon as they got it developed, because I had given them some deliverables. So I said, wow, what can I do? You know, I'm very flattered, impressed by what you've done. So they said, you know, we heard that Arthur Clarke is here. Ah, that I can do. So we went, and I think those pictures are there. They were ecstatic. Yeah, these are satellite guys, right? I mean, this is like meeting the guy, the man, for a satellite person to meet Arthur Clarke. The Clarke orbit is the geostationary orbit, but there are other orbits, and we can do good things with it for telecommunications, where we have lower latency. That's fine. So there you could say his vision has been realized. I mean, you must remember, in this country, until the 90s, our only link to the world was a satellite, right? Bangladesh, until 2006, the only link to the world was a satellite. So that's geostationary, right? So that's important. That's significant. But you look at certain other things. Let's take trust and verify, right? I mean, this is a statement attributed to Ronald Reagan, but the person who really articulated it first was Arthur C. Clarke, which is use the satellites to verify what is actually going on. Now, this idea, if you just take that idea, I would say he was one of the first to say, right? So that vision, I would say, is originally it was applied to deterrence, to nuclear bombs and control of weapons of mass destruction. But now it's being used for much more. I mean, positive reasons, not to prevent horrible things from happening, but to do good things. So, you know, I mean, his vision is still being moved forward. But I think the sort of thing that I think about when I think of Arthur C. Clarke and his sort of outrageous imagination is this idea that the whole world should have a single time zone. So I was on a panel with him on one of these video conferences, and he said that. And when the mics were switched off, I said, you're crazy. I said, only you can get away with this kind of rubbish, right? That's what I told him. I mean, you could talk to him like that, yeah? But today, I mean, if you really look at what's happened with the business process outsourcing industry and with people like me, for example, I mean, sometimes I have to think about 7 p.m., 8 p.m. as a work slot, because I have so many calls with the East Coast that I have to take at that time. So for me, 7 p.m., for them, 9 a.m. right? So we are, in a sense, looking at a single time zone, right? All that he did is he said it in very stark terms. Let's abolish all the time zones and have one. It gets your attention, let's say, right? Gets you thinking. Sure, people should read his books, no? I can remember one of my children wanted to meet him and I said, how many of his books have you read? So to find that particular child had not read any. I said, no way. You don't read, you don't go. Right? So I think, you know, I mean, he's a writer. And his work lives through his writing. That's over. You know, it's film, so whatever. To me, he's a man of ideas. Ideas should be celebrated as ideas, no?